Aion Classic is a really amazing MMORPG, and like for any other MMORPG, it's not a good thing when lots of players get banned. And that is exactly what is happening on North America servers lately. Stay with me for the next few minutes to hear all about Banwave, which is not making happy lots of players, and Aion Classic release in China. Yes, you heard good, China. Let's dive into video, and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel to see more Aion videos in the future. Okay, let's see first what is happening on North America servers. So I will move here on Aion Classic North America official forum, and on this part of the forum you can actually see what is happening. Every second post, almost every post, is about Steel Rake bans. So what is actually Steel Rake? For all of you who are not playing Aion Classic, or if you never played Aion before, Steel Rake is one of the dungeons in Aion. And what is happening regarding that bans? Well, looks like NC have following criteria regarding Steel Rake bans. If you are in Steel Rake doing harpings and leave the dungeon to go turn in the quest, get the quest again, then go back inside Steel Rake repeatedly for the turn in cycle, that's considered as exploiting and you will get a ban. On the other hand, if you don't do that, if you don't do the harping turnings 12 times a day or the entry quest exploit, then you should be fine. So we have here like two opinions, right? One opinion is opinion of developers of the game, NC. In their opinion, players are exploiting Steel Rake. And on the other hand, we have opinion of players, which are actually thinking also on one correct way, that if something exists in the game which you can do, right, to make some kind of advantage for your character, well, why not to do it, right? So if NC really mind, if they don't like what is happening with Steel Rake, they should implement some kind of update, some kind of patch to fix that, right? So just remove that option from the game. And regarding this ban, right, in any other MMORPG also, right, if something exists in the game which will give to players some kind of advantage, right, you have to know one thing. Players will do that, right? I know it's exploiting something, right? Whatever it is, it doesn't have to be Steel Rake. We are talking here today about Steel Rake bans. However, it doesn't matter what it is, right? If something in the game exists which players can use to their advantage, they will do that. No doubt about that. So, developers of the game, in this case NC, have two options. Either to give ban to that players, which is actually happening right now, or second option, which you would agree probably is the best option, better option, is to actually fix that thing, to remove that option, even to that you'll be able to exploit something from the game. Make some kind of update, patch, fix that thing, remove that in-game content which players are exploiting. Of course, I'm not talking here about removing Steel Rake completely from the game or in generally any other feature from the game which players are exploiting. However, just do something, you know? You have that tools, developers of the game have that option to fix that things. But as you can see, this is happening lately on North America servers. If you are playing Aion Classic on North America servers, you should avoid to do that thing regarding Steel Rake. What else to do? Other than that, you'll get banned. So regarding this ban, Steel Rake ban, but in generally, right, regarding this kind of bans, like I said, in MMORPG games, if something exists which can be exploited by players, players will do that, right? There is no question about that, right? So it's always better option for developer of the game to remove that kind of thing from the game, right? Don't leave that door even open. If that door is open, well, players will go throughout that door. They will go inside. So just close that door and that's it, right? No point to give lots of bans. So we will see what will happen in the future regarding that situation, but probably it will be the same, right? Just try to avoid to get banned. In the meanwhile, let's check what is happening in China regarding Aion Classic, and big thank you to PandaPig69, one of my viewers, for letting me know about this. Because I really didn't know that Aion Classic server was launched in China on August 4th. Yes! China have Aion Classic. And here you can see post, I will put a link in description below video, and I will not read to you this whole post, but what is interesting here, check this, right here I will show you. Aion Classic provides the content of version 1.2, and in order to solve the inconvenience and balance problems that existed in the past, a partial update of a version 2.7 was applied. So we have actually same situation like Aion Classic Korea, right? 1.2 on the start with some things from 2.7. Also regarding Seals Aura, yeah, it's there, right? You can check here this Prophet's Breath. That's actually Seals Aura. And in generally all other in-game features, they're similar like what we have Aion Classic in Korea and Aion Classic in North America. So China have get Aion Classic, and now there is just a few regions left without Aion Classic. Russia, probably Aion Classic will get there eventually, right? And Europe. So regarding Aion Classic European release, I can show you here from previous week this post from Galeas, community manager of Aion Gameforge. And he was replying here, somebody was asking what is happening regarding Aion Classic. Is there any kind of news? And he was replying here, as you can see, not yet, unfortunately, but I am working on it. As soon as there is anything substantial, I'll post for sure. So as you can see, Galeas doesn't have any kind of substantial information to share with us. This post, which is standing here, I can show you here. In this part of the forum, you can see all the important topics about Aion, what is happening. This part regarding Aion Classic server is still here like for 3 months now, right? Even longer. So NC is still talking with Gameforge. They are trying to resolve some kind of technical difficulties, right? And when they do that, we'll probably get Aion Classic in Europe. But that's not for sure, even for now, right? But I think like 99% we can say we will get Aion Classic in Europe. The question is only when. And we couldn't get it sooner, right? Because there is another reason for that. Swords of Legends Online is a new MMORPG which was released, published by Gameforge recently in Western region. And of course, they will not push two MMORPGs release somewhere about the same time. There has to be some kind of period of time between releases of two MMORPGs. So I think probably somewhere on the end of this year, or maybe even the start of the next year, we will get release of Aion Classic in Europe. And information about that, well, let's hope we will hear it soon. I am following everything what is happening here regarding Aion Classic European release. In the meanwhile, of course, I am playing Aion Classic in North America and in Korea. And if I see that something interesting is happening, not only regarding Aion Classic, but regarding Aion in generally, I will let you know here on my YouTube channel. For the next week, I am preparing specific video regarding Aion 8.0, because soon, very soon, we should get Aion 8.0 new update in Europe. Let's hope that will happen this year. Probably it will. So I have already actually made few videos about Aion 8.0 changes which are coming with that new update, because I am playing Aion over there in Korea, live servers also. But I am also preparing a new video for the next week where I will go in details regarding new changes, because of course, the more I play Aion over there in Korea, more information I have get, and better I understand what is happening actually in the game. So next week, Aion 8.0 video. And of course, like I said, if I see anything new is happening regarding Aion Classic in North America, and of course, regarding Aion Classic European release, I will let you know instantly here on my YouTube channel. Also, let me know in the comments below video, what do you think about this ban wave which is happening over there on North America servers? What is your opinion regarding this Steel Rake specific thing, right? which is happening. Do you agree with developers of the game NC, or do you think there is some other solution to this problem, right? And also, let me know in the comments below video, would you play Aion Classic when we would get it in Europe? I hope you would, because I know for sure Aion Classic is truly amazing game. And even with all of these problems which are happening right in North America with bans, with Seal Zora, with Candice, it doesn't matter. Gameplay of Aion Classic still really feels amazing. And this game, even that is an old game, is still absolutely something amazing. Thank you for watching the video and subscribe to my YouTube channel to see more Aion videos in the future. See you soon.